Thank you, Jorge. Thank you, Marcelo, for your invitation. It's not a scientific presentation, but I had the opportunity, thanks to Marcelo, to implant the new one of the new carrying, the 355. And Marcelo asked me to show you some cases. We have implanted the first 355 about 7 or 8 months ago. Okay, I have nothing to disclose. So you all know the objective of ICRS implantation. It's first of all to regularize the surface, to improve and best corrected visual acuity, to reduce the refractive error, to reduce the low and higher order optical aberration, improve contact lens tolerance, allow spectacle correction, stabilize the cornea, even if we see some cases of evolution of ectasia after ring implantation, and delay or avoid transplantation. Of course, as we have seen in the previous presentation, its cornea is unique and deserves an individual assessment. How do we select the ring that we implant? The selection is based, of course, on keratometry, astigmatism, refraction, asphericity, and type of ectasia with variation according to ring thickness and arc. How to choose the diameter? We have seen the very nice presentation of Ekel Kamun, but generally, small diameters have a greater effect and they are better for advanced stages of the disease, especially when you have high amounts of sphere, and larger diameter should be considered when mesopic pupil is large or when best corrected visual acuity is more than 0.6. And as we have seen also, when a second procedure is plain, of course ICL, but also a PRK, which is often, in our experience, which is frequently done after ring implantation. So the longer the ring, the more regular flattening on the corneal surface, and with a long arc length, it's like, for example, 210 degrees, we treat mainly myopia, and with shorter rings, we mainly treat astigmatism, as we have shown regarding the effect on the opposite meridian. If we consider the arc length, the shorter the rings, the less effect on asphericity and keratometry, but high effect of cylinder. And for longer rings, we have an important effect on asphericity and especially on Q values, on keratometry values, but almost no effect of cylinders. This is an example of quite regular astigmatism. This case of myopic astigmatism is treated by implanting short segments of 90 degrees with good effect of regularization. And on the opposite, in case of PMD, with a small cylinder in the center, a longer ring like the 210 degrees, specifically designed for PMD, will flatten the cornea without inducing a cylinder. In the new developments of Medifacos, the new Keraring 355 allows to use Kera-rings for a new specific type of keratoconus, which is a nipple tip keratoconus. It's indicated for advanced central nipple tip. And the specificity of this ring is that it's very difficult to implant the ring in a tunnel. So we are obliged to realize a pocket with a femtosecond laser with a very small incision to implant the ring. So this is our first case. It was a central keratoconus with a central pachymetry of more than 400 micron, poor uncorrected visual acuity, best corrected visual acuity of 0.6, and mainly myopia in the refraction, minus 7.5. 5 diopter. So the pocket has already been done. It's a pocket of 8 millimeters, a small superior incision, and the ring is very easily placed through this incision, and the ring has to be centered in a second step on the center of the pupil. So it's the procedure is quite different. The pocket is made at a depth of 300 microns. And in the first case, the incision was a bit longer, and I decided to put a suture, which is not mandatory for this ring. Okay, this is a post-operative aspect of the ring. So this is another example of the, the same patient, the post-op, the uncorrected visual acuity went 2.1 to 0.6. There's a gain of one line of best corrected visual acuity at 5 months, and with the patient almost plano. This is a post-op topography of the of this patient. This is a differential map. You see in elevation, we have a 90 micron reduction in anterior elevation and a very high flattening effect on the cornea up to 15 diopter without inducing high amounts of astigmatism. This is a differential map on the pentacam of the same patient with this very wide area of flattening. Okay, this is the second eye of the patient. It was almost the same condition, central nipple tip, high amount of myopia, and 0.4 of best corrected visual acuity. You have seen already the patient, and here is the post-op. Uncorrected visual acuity went to very almost cone fingers, 2.5. Two lines more of best corrected visual acuity. And once again, the patient is has a plano refraction. This is a post-op, and this is a differential maps of the patient and pentacam. Okay, in conclusion, this new 355 ring is a new option in ring selection. It's more specifically designed for nipple tip keratoconus. There's a very high flattening effect, high reduction of corneal asphericity, and this once again improves the customization of the treatment. Thank you very much, and thank you, Marcelo.